Thanks so much for being here and great questions, and I'm sure you've got more, and hopefully we'll get to them somehow someday. As I mentioned, I'm a Lane County native. I was born in the old Sacred Heart Hospital. My horse farm on the Middle Fork is an integral part of the rural economy. That's part of what's earned me the support of a bunch of crusty rural Republicans, even though I'm pretty much a dyed-in-the-wool Democrat, because when we get down to cases on real local issues, it's problem-solving that matters, not the tribal flag that you go under. I've worked as a ranch hand, a blacksmith, an educator, and an entrepreneur. My basic platform summary when I talk to voters at their doorstep, as I've done thousands of times, is that I'm running to protect our clean water, remaining wildlife habitat, and to build prosperity in our rural communities, working from the ground upward with local small businesses and grassroots folks, instead of continuing to do what our county commissioners are doing, which is big tax breaks for the outside companies. When they gave a tax break to Weyerhaeuser for the mill in Cottage Grove under the enterprise zone mechanism that's supposed to allow this hokey trading of jobs for tax breaks, the contract actually said Weyerhaeuser just had to add zero jobs to get hundreds of thousands of dollars of money that we have to make up, either by lost services or more taxes. They didn't get in big political trouble for that. So more recently, when they did the enterprise zone tax break for International Paper, the contract said International Paper just couldn't cut more than 10% of its jobs in return for a tax break. So what that means is International Paper is putting in some big new piece of machinery they want a tax break on. It's going to take 10% of people's jobs away, and we're helping pay for it. That's got to end. We take that money that's not going with one-way tickets to the Wall Street owners of these big outside companies, and instead we put it into a local revolving loan fund with sideboards, so we actually use it to help our local small businesses. So we don't just talk about rural economic development. We fund it. We help businesses do what they need to do to survive and thrive. So this is a chance in this election to replace a member of the Old Boy Network with a proven progressive problem solver. I'd be honored to have your vote in May.